Good morning, dear colleagues. I am glad to represent our simple but important for real medicine practice clinical investigation on the study of cardiac valves involvement in ankylosing spondylitis patients taking different treatment. All authors declare no conflicts of interest. Some moment about ankylosing spondylitis is a form of inflammatory arthritis that primarily affects spine. Ankylosing spondylitis symptoms usually begin before age of 14 and often as early as the teens and 20s. The lower back pain is worse after inactivity or when patients wake up. The final stage of this process is ankylosis. That's why early diagnosis and the treatment of ankylosing spondylitis is critical. Treatment aims to reduce pain and symptoms, help you maintain normal posture, reduce complications and comorbidities. While chronic inflammatory lower back pain is a pivotal symptom of ankylosing spondylitis, the disease can have a wide-ranging impact on patients' health and well-being. The development of extraskeletal ankylosing spondylitis manifestations, including heart wall damage, impairs patient health and increases risk of death. Commonly prescribed medications for ankylosing spondylitis include non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and different classes of biologics, which are targeted drugs that act on immune system pathways to reduce inflammation. The most common cardiac complications for ankylosing spondylitis are conduction disorders and valves insufficiency. These conductions were found up to 20% in ankylosing spondylitis patients. Because inflammation plays a pivotal role in ankylosing spondylitis and other autoimmune diseases, pathogenesis, and cardiovascular diseases, the effects of anti-inflammatory treatment on cardiovascular disease progression are being studied. According to a series of studies, the ankylosing spondylitis therapy by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, disease modifying antiarrhythmic drugs and biologics has an ambiguous effect on the cardiovascular system. Therefore, the assessment of cardiac damage in patients with different therapy is relevant. So the aims of our study was to determine the frequency of heart valve damage in ankylosing spondylitis patients with different therapy. 49 patients with ankylosing spondylitis were examined in rheumatology department of Research Institute of Clinical Experimental Lymphology in Novosibirsk. The diagnosis met the modified 1984 New York criteria. All patients had signed informed consent. Patients were 39 years. All patients were male. The most of patients had moderate or high activity. The disease duration was at least 14 years. 38 patients received non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. 30 patients have sulfasalazine, 8 methotrexate, and 1 combination of therapy. 16 patients received biologics. All of patients were treated in accordance with the clinical recommendations, and we done all this procedure of investigation. Our result, the most common manifestations were left atrium dilation, aortic insufficiency and mitral insufficiency, and diastolic dysfunction. And these clinical manifestations is not correlates with other comorbidities, for example, with arterial hypertension. Left atrial dilation is the most damaged manifestation. cardiac valves were less likely to be affected in patients with NSAIDs. It means non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Mitral insufficiency were found in 13% patients from NSAIDs group, compared with 4 patients, 44% cases in opposite groups. Aortic insufficiency was found in 18% cases, compared with 15% respectively. Diastolic dysfunction were found in 15 patients with NSAIDs, compared with 16 cases in patients without NSAIDs. No significant differences were found in frequencies or cardiac valve lesions between the groups of patients taking biologics and DMARDs. So we present the conclusion that therapy with non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs may be useful to prevent the cardiac valve damage in patients with ankylosing spondylitis and have a cardioprotective effect. Thanks for attention. This is my business card for communication to take additional information and scientific cooperation. Thanks.